I think it's something that people like choose not to think about until they're like directly confronted with it. Like even now, like at, like the things that like I hear people who I know love me and like who are my friends like say and like do and like the way that like, you know, like just to make one's life more difficult in general, you know, like, you know, you're walking too fast. You know, I can't walk that fast, but still like you're going to sprint ahead of me. That's ableist. You know, like if you really loved to be around me, spend all this time with me, like when you want to walk abreast with me, like when you want to wait for me, like instead of like trying to make me like function at what you think is ideal performance for your own life. I just.
Or on that, when your friends who are very close to you think that by pushing you, motivating you and saying, I know you can do this a little bit more, they think that's helpful. And it's hard because sometimes, you know, that has been a huge positive influence in my life for like physical therapy and like my parenting, like my mom doing that. But other times, it's hard to really convey, no, fuck you, I'm really tired listening to you right now. Like, I need to take it slow. And then there's a whole other issue of, well, people too, we can also just be lazy as well. And like, when are we like, when are we actually not really that able? Or when are we feeling like, you'll do it for me, you know? So it's a balance.
I agree. I think like, also like, I know that my disability also comes with a level of fatigue and like the way that like partners perceive my fatigue, which can also be brought on by like a lot of medications too. Like that's something that like can pretty much be across the board, like both with like some physical disabilities and like a lot of medications, is like the understanding that like there can be fatigue involved. And I feel like the way that people see like sex is that like it's best when it's tireless and it goes on forever and like I'll be here for a year. And it's like, okay, sometimes I'm up for that, but like other times it's like I'm very sleepy, you know, and I don't feel like it should be taken as like a character flaw, you know, like it's like the idea of ideal performance is one that is inherently ableist, I think.
And as someone with like anxiety and panic disorder, I definitely understand like that too, like the like, okay, I can do this for maybe like half an hour, but then I'm gonna have to do something else, or I'm gonna have to go to sleep, or I'm gonna have to get out of my brain for a little while. Like, and the whole like, put the issue of like people pushing you,
yeah,
can be very difficult when you've got things like panic disorder, because you'll just be like, people will be pushing you, and that'll make you more anxious, and so you'll just be like, and then eventually like I don't know, I'm just like broken down over people being like, Sarah, can you grab me this, and I'll be like, no. And like cry in my room for 3 hours, and like it's just how the cookie crumbles sometimes.
And like the frustration when like performance does not meet what other people think of as adequate, you know,
yeah.
Like regardless of that, whether or not that's like in regards to ability or like just someone being a tool like that day, like it's just like I think it's something that like is very easily internalized, you know.
Yeah.
So if anybody has any like closing questions or comments, concerns.
Well, I also think that in terms of like general misconceptions, there tends to be this false notion of like folks who are differently abled not like having emotions in the same way that like other people do, like able-bodied people do. I think that also, you know, definitely plays into like the very active like disrespect and like disacknowledgement of like people's differences. So like thinking that like behavior is like more excusable because like somebody is disabled and like might not perceive your behavior as like as fucking problematic as it is, or that it doesn't hurt in the same way.
Which I think just ties into a larger denial of personhood to people with disabilities.
Yeah.
You know, I just think to be desired sexually is something that people want on a very intrinsically instinctive level. you know, like people, most people want to be desired, like be seen as desirous by others and by themselves, you know? And I feel like that's one of the first things that people withdraw when they find out that a person is disabled or when they understand a person to be disabled, which I think is like, it becomes a wholesale denial of personhood in a lot of ways.
Also, like the assumption of because you have a physical disability, you are stupid. Like that's
yeah, especially correlated with speech impediments. I actually had someone from Hampshire last year. Yeah, they were researching friends, and they made a comment to me that they were surprised at the extent of my vocabulary. And I was like, thank you. Like, and then I walked away and I had to think, like, what an ignorant fuck. Like, seriously, like. And it's just whenever, like, I'm on the phone, you know, people either perceive me as being, you know, completely ignorant or like a child. Like, oh, is mommy or daddy there? Like, no, you fuck asses. Like, no. Yeah. So.
Well, I think we're going to wrap up unless anybody has any final comments. All right. Well, you can email us questions or comments at getwettv@gmail.com, GETWETTV. Yeah.
For questions, comments, complaints, or concerns, email me at getwettv@gmail.com. That's GETWETTV@gmail.com. Do it.